I've already shared my screen. The next one. I already shared my screen. I hope you can see it. My name is Martin Reulinger. You can see that here on the right top of the screen. I've selected an organization for an internal Floor Holland auction number for Froyo Floor Holland in Rijnsburg. I can use this for this demo without it showing some private information. If you see this this screen, the first I'd like to show is what you can do with the user menu. Here on the right top, you can click on your name or you can click on the three dots. And if you do so, the user menu will appear. If you have multiple organizations, you can select for which grower you like to see the information. You can also multi-select. You can also select more than one organization than only one. What's very interesting is here is the settings page. With the settings page, there's a lot of different settings for all kinds of screens that you can change. It's a quite a long list if you browse through it. I'll show you during the demo, we're on a specific screen, what you can change in the setting. But some things I already want to show, for example, is in on top of this settings list, the show pieces by unit. At this moment, it's turned off. When I turn this on, everywhere in the screen, you will see the number of package and the number of pieces within a package instead of the total number of pieces, for example. So these kinds of global settings will be used on different places in the application. I've now turned this option on. When it's green, it's on, and you can see directly the number of pieces.
Cool. Listen, we've got this thing at 11, you remember? Okay. Cool, where are you?
Is this a question for insights? Well, or?
Yeah, that's better. I've got some stuff to do afterwards. I think it's number 25 on that road from Atlanta. Yeah.
It was Emma, I've just muted your microphone. No problem. Another thing you can see over here, for example, is to show direct orders. You can choose for direct orders if you like to see them on the original delivery date, the order date, or the expected invoice date. And for example, if you want to check your revenue with the invoice message you get from Floor Holland, you can best use the expected invoice date. And this way, the numbers you'll see will match with your invoice. If you put on delivery date, you can more see from, hey, on which date are the my direct orders delivered. So you can choose on which date the direct orders are shown. I will remain this on expected invoice date at this moment as a setting. So there's all kinds of different settings you can use to change the behavior of insights to have impact of all different parts of insights. During the demo, we'll come back to the settings screen where it's very useful. Another very interesting page is the subscription page. At this page, you can change the end date of your subscription. For example, if you're a seasonal grower who don't need to use insights for the whole year, you can stop over here your subscription. You can change this and I say, I don't want continuous. You can use an end date. You can change it and then the subscription will end automatically. And when you like to restart again, for example, within a new season, you can always start at the moment you like. You go to Insights, you create a new subscription, and you can go directly.
Like Uber. So Uber drivers are all covered from us. So imagine an Uber driver getting into a road accident. We've saved their life.
The new attendant, Chris, also muted, and you can change the end date of your subscription. A third page I'd like to show, and this is quite new, it is added recently in this summer, is that you can see all the users who are coupled to your organization as a grower. This is quite a long list, but this is an internal number, so lots of internal colleagues of Floor Holland are attached to this grower. But if you what you can do over here is for each user, you can check if he can use insights. It's the first column. So if I disable this function, this user, Anil, cannot use insights anymore. But you can also say, I want to only disable it here for a specific part of insights. For example, if I say, he can use MarketView, but I don't want this user to see all my statistics. You could, for example, disable the statistics option. And at this moment, with these settings, the user, Anil, you can use, for example, the market view and the report, but you can't use statistics part of insight. So you can change the behavior of all the users who are coupled to your organization. And the users you see here, they're also invited within Floriday. Within Floriday, the main account user of an organization can invite other people. And here, when the invitation is accepted, you can change over here the behavior within Insights. And for you, for lots of growers, for example, there are logistic handlers or agents who are users to you for your organization, and you can see over here or what they can do or what they can see. I'll go to the dashboard. The dashboard option is most of the times the first screen that you use if you enter Insights. What you see over here, I think that's most of people know that already, is an overview of the revenue from the last 2 weeks. Over here, for this grow, it's only direct, for only clock sales, but if you have direct sales, you will see that here as well. And there are all kinds of widgets with information. And there is a widget with most important buyers, with clock lots, for example, with products, all kinds of different things. But you can change this dashboard for the way it's representing for your own favorite settings. For example, if you say Vanuit is most important, it's not very interesting for me, you can put this button over here, and if you click on it, the widget will disappear. And I think clock lots is very nice, direct sales I don't need, this overview is not very useful for me. You can change them. Corrections, hey, I think that's very important, I'll put them above. And this is with the other buttons, you can change the location of this widget with these arrows up and down. You can say, hey, this goes up and it goes to position up. And with the other button, you can place it to position down. For now, I've here revenue, corrections on second place, and here is the average price widget. And widgets that have been hide, you can make them visible again with this orange button, yellow orange button on the right bottom of the screen. If you click on this, you can say, hey, these are the widgets that are currently hidden, and you can show them again if you like. So you can change the behavior of which widgets are shown. It's a setting, it will be saved for you as a user, but it will be saved for each different device you use. So if you use this on your smartphone, it has its own settings for which you want to see, because on a smartphone, maybe you want to see some different information than on your computer. And on your computer, if you save this, it has its own settings. So it's not coupled to you as a user, but it's coupled to the device you are working on. Any questions about the replacing of the settings for widgets? Very good. Another thing that could be very useful is the columns over here. You have some different columns with averages, and sometimes it gets some people a little bit busted from what, a little bit confused from what's exactly the difference. Averages, there are three averages shown over here. The first average is your own average. This, for this example, for this row is 73 cents. The second average is the second one, but excluding pre-sales. So you have a different, you have two averages for your lot. One is with pre-sales included, and the other is exclusively with pre-sales. It's giving a very lots of information about what the price level was during the auctioning itself. And pre-sale price is something that is created the day before it's sold on the clock, so it gives more information about the actual prices on the clock itself paid in this morning. And the third average is the clock average, and that is the overall average for the same product on the same main characteristic for the same location. For example, these two averages are the same. That means that none part of this lot is sold as pre-sale. The clock average is a little bit lower, it's 46.9 cents. So the average price of this grower was almost 30 cents higher than the average price at the clock for this actual day. And what we added this summer also is the auction time and some extra columns. Here you see this gear wheel. And with this gear wheel, you can always go directly to the settings of a specific part of Insights. At the beginning of this demo, I showed the settings from the main user menu. But if you click on this gear wheel, you go directly to the dashboard settings. And for example, you can here change the number of settings. For example, if I want to see pre-sale or pre-sale price, I can select it. At this moment, they're not selected, but I can turn them on. I can hide this average, for example. You can do some settings. I also want to see the quality. And if I go back to the dashboard screen, you'll see the some changes have been made. Now I also have a column with quality. It was not shown before. The pre-sale is shown over here. And the average excluding pre-sales is this has been disappeared because I have I hide that column. So you can change the columns you see over here. And the first setting I changed this today was the setting from do I want to see all pieces or the number of buckets and the number of pieces in a bucket. Now you can see here the behavior. This is 1x50. So it means one big bucket with 50 pieces in it. And so it's shown like this over here. And for this example, these are three buckets with 120 pieces per bucket. And if I disable that setting, it will show 360 as a total summary for this. And this is something for a lot of you. That's it's quite a lot of use because it's directly giving information about the selling results every morning. But you also have, if you like, all the detailed transactions with every buyer you're selling or other widgets shown over here for direct sales or products for most important buyers. And some new widgets will be added in the future as well. Any questions about the dashboard? If you like, you can also set your question in the chat.
I will read the chat as well. Yes, I want to ask a question, please.
Yes.
I tried quite a few times to download it to Excel. Even now, while you were talking, I did try it on my mobile, and the results are very poor. Still poor. Can you show us how you download the?
For downloading, what's very important are the user settings. If you go to the settings, what I showed the first time, I didn't mention this one, but this is the fourth one, and that's the export settings. And what's very important when you use Excel is how the separators and the decimal points are used. These are different in every language. It's depending on the original settings of your Excel on your own computer or your own smartphone. For example, at this moment there's a semicolon as a separator and a comma for me as a decimal separator. It's a settings used in the Netherlands by default in Excel. But if you change this, for example, to the comma as a separator and a point, there's more the international setting that is often used. And also the same is for date format. If it doesn't recognize dates as a date, you can always change the date format. So if it doesn't load correctly in Excel, it's best to change these settings. Most of the times, if you change this to a comma and this to a point, it will be imported correctly.
Thank you.
But please try and let me know if it works.
Yeah, I try 20 minutes, okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
If anyone has a question and maybe doesn't have a microphone to use, you can also type it in the chat, and I will read these messages and I will answer the questions here in the presentation. Okay, I'll go to the next part of the application. It's the daily report. The daily report gives a very detailed information about the auction process in the morning, about your position within the auction group, about the prices from other growers in the group. You can see quite a lot of information. It's a screen. There hasn't been much new things created within this, but I'll show a short demo for maybe not if not everyone has already seen how it works. What's one of the most important things is these kinds of screens for each auction group you're using. For example, this is a Clock 5 group in Rijnsburg. You can see directly from what's my position within the auction group. These are the green columns, and the gray columns. The gray columns are all lots of other growers within the same auction group. And if you go with your mouse or with your finger on your smart screen over this graphic, you can see for each product from, hey, who's the grower? What kind of product did he sell? What was the main characteristic? And what was the average price? And you can see within such, hey, what was my position? How was the price development within the group? Was it a raising market? Was it going down the prices? Why did I get a specific price? Is it a little bit lower or higher as I expected? And what happened to other growers? So it gives you lots of information about the price process in the morning. Below the graphic, there also your own lots are here shown over here. Here's also the average and the highest price is shown. What you can do over here is click on a row and you will see also the detailed transactions. So for example, for this lot with three pieces, it's just show is bought by two different buyers. You can see Sylvina, the first one bought two pieces, the second one, and you can see here the price development. The first price was 40 cents, the second one was 70 cents. And specifically for lots with lots of different buyers, that you can exactly see how the prices development were within the lot. As you can see this for all different lots. What could be useful as well is if you go to these three dots, on the same line as the from the same row as the auction group, there are also here three dots. And if you do that, you will see all the transactions within a group directly. So you see these are three different lots have been auctioned, and you can see in one overview all the transactions that have been made and the price development. And what is also can be useful, specifically when you're auctioned in a group with lots of different product groups. You say it's nice, but not every product is comparable with my own product. You can set a specific filter, for example. I check here for Phlox. I will do Phlox paniculata. I have to say apply. And will only see the data from this one. In this specific auction group, there are only now two lots shown, and you can see only Phlox products. So you can make a better comparison with the same products. And you could do this on product groups. When you say, hey, I want to use some specific filters on a specific product, you can also say, hey, I want to see only this products or a specific characteristic you can use. You can use all kinds of different filters to compare your product as good as possible with products that you are almost the same as that you use for yourself. So you compare your prices. This can be done for the actual day. This is October 5, but you can also go back in time and say, hey, I want to see how it was on the September the 1st or any date you like. So you can always say go back in time with this option. Today was 5 October, yes. Any questions about the daily report? I'll go to the market view. Daily report is essential. You can only use it if you're auctioning for yourself. If you do only direct sales, you don't see much information in daily report. But in market view, you can always check all the prices from all auctioned products. I will make a new filter, for example. You can check for the price for today. You can also select the price just for a longer period if you like, but I'll remain for today. For example, if I go to Phlox, you can here check the name. I'll set an option on that filter, and it will show all the Phlox products auctioned today. You can see the all different settings, the average price, the auction piece applied. Here's a column that's not by default the main characteristic, but here you can see directly breakdown in columns on the characteristic, but that's a setting. I will show later how you can change that. And for the all kinds of group, you can say you can in the settings you can choose which columns you will see. If I change this, you can go here to the gear wheel again. In the gear wheel, select the columns to display. It's shown from hey, what columns can you choose? For example, this one I can hide. You can say, I want to see if something is not sold. I want to see, for example, the direct pieces and the highest price, but not the piece per location. And I go back because I've changed all kinds of columns. I have a completely different view. Now I have the average price, highest price for this product, the auction piece applied to dairy pieces, if available. It's not always available, it's depending also on the number of growers who have directly sold flocks today. And you can see the average price for each location.
So it is, excuse me, can you show us on this point how you can see the quality?
Yes. The quality can be added over here as well as a specific column. And so over here, you can select quality as a column. I go back to the screen. And it will show here a column with quality. So now, for example, you can see for the flocks Bright Eyes, you can see the R1 quality, R2 quality, and you see the average price. And for example, for this in Alsmeer, no price is displayed. It means that nothing has been sold as A2 in Alsmeer today. In Rijnsburg, it is. Dus in Rijnsburg, R2 flocks price was 8 cent today, the average price. So if you can add the quality as a column over here. Also, you can filter on it. This is using columns. If you say, hey, I am only interested in A1 as quality, you can also set it here in the filter. Here is the quality. And if I say I want to only see R1, I can set R1 as a filter. I apply. The filters you affect was shown over here. And now this quality column is not useful anymore because I have set the filter. It will only show, always show only R1. So I can remove it because it's giving the same results. And so you can see the only R1 quality. If you click on a specific product, you can also have a breakdown on different characteristics. This is also a setting which you want to use. There are all different kinds of options before it. At this moment, it's length, country of origin, and quality. But you can change it over here with also in the settings for market view, is the breakdown type. View, you can say I want to only see the primary characteristic, I want to see most important, if I want to see all that have been used by the grower. For example, if I do primary, I go back to the screen and I click on the same product, now you only see on length. And if you the less characteristics you use for breakdown, the more information you see. It's always something to do also with the three grower rule, because it's always it's always counting from how much different growers have delivered a specific product for this specific length. And now you can see it will not show anything for this kind, but if, is there anyone? It is no. But it could be that if on length you can see the numbers, but if you do a quality also on length or weight or other specific characteristics, the numbers will disappear because the detailed it's too much detail sample to show the number of growers. The average price is always shown. You all see the average price and highest price for these kinds of things, but it could be that the number of pieces will disappear if you do a breakdown on lots of different characteristics. What could also be very useful, and that's something that is new functionality we added in August, that is the bookmark option, and it's shown by this picture over here. I've now created a selection on product group flocks with a quality I. I can make a bookmark of it, and I call that flocks. Save it. I'll remove some bookmarks I used in an earlier stage of just one bookmark. Now I can reset my filter and I say I want to see completely different something. I want to see roses, and I want to see roses, an extra filter within it for specific products, for example, of roses with a length of 50 and 60, don't know, and 40. Combine some things and apply. So now I see a rose large flowered for these three lengths. And here it is. If I click on it, you can see only these three lengths, I hope. Yes, so 60, 50, and 40, because all others have been filtered out. And say, hey, this is also very useful. I want to save this as a bookmark as well. You can create a second one, roses 40 to 60. I'll give it as a name. And now you can save, hey, but the flocks, I want to go back to the flocks. You can click on the bookmark, you go back to flocks, and it will directly use the flux filter again. So you can make different filter sets, specifically interesting when you have different product groups you use as a grower, or if you have a number of products you're very interested in, you can combine them in one combination, use it as a bookmark, and you could change very quickly with the bookmark option to different views. And this was the flux, and I can change the flux as well. If it's not only is the A1, but I remove this one, and I save it again. Say save, and now the flux. No, that didn't work quite correctly. I'll save this one. Flux A1. I'll save it, and it's saved again. That doesn't make a new one, doesn't matter very much. But now I have two ones, I'll remove this one. And I still have the bookmarks that I can use. Just I can switch between the bookmarks for rows and for flux. Any questions for the market view? I'll go to the statistics session. Within the statistics, if you open it the first time, it could be that it's empty, or it could be that there are a couple of predefined reports available. I'll create some new ones for the different types we use over here. With statistics, you can do lots of different things, but you will see in this demo what kinds of report types there are. And at this moment, there are 7 different reports, but we're already developing a new one. I'll mention that at the end of this demo. First one you can use is a product demo. And a product demo, you can, for example, make a product overview for last month. You can, for every report, you can choose if you share it with colleagues within your own organization. If you disabled it, it's only a report that you will see as a user for yourself. If you shared it, or other users that are coupled to your organization can see that report as well. We create this report. This is the name of the report. You can change it over here if you like. But this is very important for every report, is that's the period which is used for. I give it the name last month. It says the last 7 days. It's not correctly. You can do two different things with the reports. You can choose manually a starting date and an end date, or you can choose for a pre-selected period. For example, I mentioned that it was the previous month, so we'll choose previous month, and I will apply it. And now it's the previous month, and you will see the 1st of September until the end of September. It's calculating the report, there it is. And you can choose to use it as a relative date, what you choose, of a non-relative date. A relative date will always be the previous month, because if I check this report in November, it will show October. If I check it in December, it will show November. So it will always be the previous month. And when I turn this off, it will remain September. It's not relative, it's the previous month at this moment. So it will always be September 21. But if you do this, it will always be the previous month. Now you can see over here, this is the product report. It's all lots of different products because it's an internal number, and lots of different things are auctioned with this number for all kinds of products. It's a long list, so we use a filter to make it a little bit looks like it how it looks like with most other growers. For example, if I choose roses over here and I put it on apply, you will get a list with the products with only roses. You can also see which filters are active over here, and you can remove a filter if you like. Here you'll see the list of of roses that have been auctioned in the previous month. It will show your own average, but also the clock average and the clock number of pieces. That's a little bit of your own information, but also a benchmark from how the total of numbers sold on the clocks are at Floor Holland and what the total average is. What you can also do is do a breakdown of which buyers have been bought this product. So if you click on it, you can see even, hey, these are the different buyers that have been buying this. What's also very could be very useful is to add here some extra columns to this table. You could do some different things. You can say, from, hey, I want a specific characteristic. For example, I've added the length. As you see now, the The characteristic is shown as length, and you can also choose an extra column, for example, on quality. Now I have two extra columns added to it, there's a roses gemengd, 50 centimeters, A1 quality, and you see everything over here. It's all A1, as it looks like. Yes, so you can change this behavior of this table by adding different kinds of columns. You can also say a location or sales method. You can choose what you like to see as an extra column, and you can choose to use, if you like, an extra characteristic, but it's free to use to add two extra columns. And what you do over here is always be saved in this report. Just if I open this report again, it will always save the last settings I've made, and you get the same overview as when you created it or changed it for the last time. It's quite an easy report to create, and you can do it also for the actual date. You can do it for the actual week, but you can also do it for a complete year if you like. If you see, honestly, a year overview of all my products, you can use that as well. Second overview, a little bit similar, but also a little bit different, is a buyer overview. For example, the buyer overview last week, I will name it, and create. Last week is not last 7 days, but it's the previous week. It's this one. I'll do the same thing with the date as I explained before. What you see over here is a list of all the buyers that have been buying products from me. It's most of the times quite a long list on the clocks, because lots of different buyers are active over there. It shows a number of rows over here, but you can also say I want to see all the growers. You can choose how much are displayed over here. And if you click on a specific buyer, you always also see what he has been buying at you. So you can see when this buyer Van Egmond has bought 5 different products, and you can see what has he been paying for and what was the average price he paid. So you can directly see what this buyer has bought. If you want to create only the top buyers, it could be that lots of buyers have only bought one bucket or not very much. You can choose also to set a minimum of pieces. For example, if I checked it, set it to 100, I had 50 growth, now if only 19 are left. If I say, hey, I want to see only all buyers who have at least 200 pieces bought, you will see only 7 buyers left. So now we show the top 10, you see only the buyers with a minimum of 200 pieces. And you can do over here, select, for example, on column prices, and you can see who has bought the highest average price of the highest price overall of the highest revenue. You can choose on which column you want to order this this table. Now, this is very useful to get a quick overview of your buyers for a specific period. The third one is week revenue. It's also very interesting. I'll give it also the week revenue history name, history, for example. By default, it will show all the revenue for the last 3 years. And this is the default settings. You can see here for this year, previous year, and the year before, the total revenue, number of pieces, average price, all these kinds of things. You can see it over here in a graphic. And here is a table with all the data. And you see for every week number, you see the revenue, number of pieces, average price, cumulative column, and the growth. When the numbers are red, it is lower as the year before. When it's black, it's higher than the year before. You can see here, for example, this is 1,500 euros. Last year was 4,084 euros, so it's a little bit higher. So we'll show over here. But in this week, in week 19, this was 600, and the year before was 730, so it's less. So that's why it's here displayed in red. But here you can see exactly what for each week, what your revenue is, and you compare it with the year before. And you see over here, these are the weeks that are still running. At this moment, we're in week 40. Also here, there are some settings. You see also a gear wheel. And when you click on the gear wheel, you can always change some things. It says, show a cumulative graph. It's possible. I do select it. I will show the difference. Show pieces sold is turned on. Show pieces sold cumulative. I'll turn it on as well. If I go back to that line, now you see not the revenue for week, but you see how it's developing, and it is cumulative now at this moment within the graphic. This is a setting you can use. And for now here, you see also the revenue is cumulative. And the number of pieces is also cumulative. So you can see now directly from, hey, what is the total number for this year? It's cumulative instead of that you see the number of per week. But it's also a setting you can choose for yourself what you like to see. And what this also can be used for, and that is, I'll make a new one. I can also use this to create the buyer analysis week. I create the same report. This is the report the last 3 years for all the revenue, but I can add, for example, a buyer filter to it. We saw that Egmond was an active coper, Gebroeders, this one, I think. I can use this as a filter. So I search for a specific buyer. And what I see right now is what is his total revenue for the whole year, for these 3 years? What are the number of pieces sold, the average price? And you can see directly for each week what this buyer has been doing with my products. So this buyer has bought for 64 euros in the week one, zero. And you can see for each week how this buyer is developing. And is he buying more or less than last year, for example? And then you can use it also with the combination with other filters. But this could, for example, be very useful with your largest buyers. Van, hey, are they growing or are they buying less pieces for my products? And you can see how they are developing for your sellings. Very interesting. So it's a combination of this report with a specific filter on a specific buyer. The fourth report, the time period compare. And you can use this, for example, for a report on Valentine. Create. And I can compare time periods with each other, and I can, the time periods can be created by myself. So I'm free to choose any time period I like with another time period from the same length. For example, I want to see the last 2 weeks before Valentine's Day for this year and the years before. Well, how was the price development? I don't have to can use a predefined date, but I will go to the period before Valentine. Valentine was on this, so I will check from the Monday before, from the 1st of February until Friday before Valentine's Day, for example. It was, I can do it to Sunday, that doesn't matter. Apply. Now we can see what was the price development within this week for each date. So I can see the revenue, the number of pieces, and the average price over here. Now I can add a second period to it when I want to compare this with 2020. With my keyboard, I can change the year to 20. I can go to the same period. It's not exactly the same. It's the days are different each year a little bit. The 14 was on Friday. I will start on the same on a Monday. And this is the end date it's using. So on the Sunday, this is the last 2 days are in the week. It doesn't matter really, but you can see that the starting date is a little bit different, but it can exactly compare now in this graphic from week one from this year, current year, that was orange, and the purple is the year before. You can see the number of pieces, and you can see the average price development, and also within this table. And I can add a third period as well, if I like, so I can also take 29 as a period with it. And I say for now, I compare, how was it here? I'll check this period, start on 28, apply. So it is, every time it's a little bit different in date what I compare, but I can exactly compare the Mondays in the 2 weeks before the Valentine's Day period. And you can see from how much did I sell this day, how much pieces did I deliver, and how much was the average price fulfillment. And you can use also these kind of things to make a planning for the new period. For example, if you create this report for the Christmas period, you can check exactly from, hey, how does it look like Christmas last year, and what can I what could be a good number of pieces to deliver this year. And you can here you can remove this, and you go, you're free to compare any period you like. So if I want to compare this with I don't know, the Mother's Day in the Netherlands, I'll choose here 26th of April, and I can compare that as well. So you're free to compare any period you like. It doesn't have to be the same time period, but only the length of the period will always be the same. And this is without any filter, but you can also use any other filter, for example, on a sales method, on location. Filters are always the same, or specific characteristics, specific buyers. You can always add extra filters to this report to make it more specific for how do you need the information. For so far the time period, I'll skip this one, but I'll go to the product history. Product history is one of the latest reports that has been added. Create. It will be not very very loading very fast for this grower. This grower has hundreds of different products every year. Not bad, I think. But it will directly show also the three different years. But what you see over here is a combination of two other reports. You see the list of all the products that have been used by this grower. And you see the average, then the total summaries for the different years. I'll make it a little bit more easier to read by specifying a specific product group. Alstroemeria, for example. If I apply this group, it will be a little bit easier to read. Now you see all the different Alstroemeria products. You see for each product, you see from what was the what was the average price, what was the grower, how you can see exactly how this looks like. And this is for all different years. You can scroll a little bit. It's on a smartphone each year as on the computer. You can do it just with your finger by swiping to the left or to the right within the table. And you can see over how it was this year, 2020, and in 2019, you compare easy on how the development of products is over the years. And it's also can be combined with all the filters that have been used in other reports as well. And this information can also be downloaded like any other table. Every table you see, you can always download. And it can be done with this button, and it will use, it's create a CSV export file, which I explained you can use to load in Excel or another application. And to do a further analysis within your own environment. It's the product history report. The most this is the most complicated. It's the most it's quite difficult to use the custom report, but it's also very powerful because you have all the other things are predefined reports with a list you cannot change, but with the custom report you can change, you can create your own your own report. For example, what I want to do in this report is a roses report, compare auction prices. So how that looks like, create this report. This report is empty if you start it for the first time, because you can create data sets that will be displayed in this overview. I will do this for the current year as a default period, and I create data sets. So first data set will show a specific filter. These are all the options you can use to create the filter set. These are the default options that have been selected. For example, I want to see my roses for my own. Yeah, this is correctly. I will set it on a specific group. You can see all the product groups that have been used by this grower. If you do press on this arrow, you can see all the different products, but I want to select the whole group, rose, large flowered, bulk resale direct, all kinds of things, and I'll save this. What I see over here is not very complicated. It's for each week. You see the average price and the number of pieces that I've been selling for roses. But what now could be interesting, I can also create a second one. For example, a setting for the same product group, roses. But I can say roses, RFH, Royal Flora Holland. Now I can, for example, go to this one, the date and auction wide. If I show the auction wide data, I can create a second data set. And here you compare the revenue of roses of whole floor world, and you compare it with your own rose prices. And you see this here in this graphic, how the how it looks like. And here you can see it also with the table for every time from what's my revenue, new floor Holland. How much pieces sold and what was the average price, so you can create your own comparison for these kinds of things. This is a very easy one on group level, but you can also do very specifically on a specific length. For example, if I do my roses my own, I say from I'll change to a specific length and go to the length, the minimum length of flower stem, that's this one. I want to see only the 60 centimeters. And I save it. It's also here shown what the actual filter set is. I should change here the things. It says own 60 centimeters. I'll save it. I say, hey, this is the rose for all. But if I compare it, I want to make it also 50 centimeters. You can add this. I can add this also 50. I will add that filter here as well with characteristics. Minimum length. I'll save it. And I have 50 and 60. Now it doesn't matter very much, but I compare 50 with 60. And so you can see you can create little very specific ones. And I can also say, hey, this is roses RFH 50, but I want to make a copy of it. And I wanted the really 60 as well. I can edit my copy that I created. I only have to change 50 to 60. And I have to change the actual filter with characteristics, the minimum length. And it was 50, but now I want to disable this option and enable this option, and I'll save it. And now I have different sets. So I have the roses 60 and the roses 50. And you can see over here the difference between them. And if you like, you can change the order how it's displayed by clicking here on revenue or on data set name. The order is free to choose. And you can also here change the order in which these data sets are shown. But you can see all kinds of different data sets you can create. You can use it, for example, if you auction on different locations, you can create a location overview. And I want to see what's in Alsmeer and what the average price from Florent in Alsmeer is for the same products that I use. You can use it to compare different lengths from your products. You can choose all kinds of different things. You're free to compare anything with anything in this overview. Only it's manual. It's a custom report, so you have to create for yourself what you like. It's very powerful, but it's a little bit more complicated, a little more difficult than the other reports to use. And the last one that looks a little bit like the customer overview is the cultivation overview. Cultivation overview. And what you can do over here is that you can set from what is the revenue for a specific product. For example, I'm a grower for roses. Yeah, for roses, so I'll do the same filtering as I did in the customer report. I choose roses as a filter. Okay, but now I can add some extra different things. From how much plants do I have? I have 2,000 plants, and I have 500 square meters with roses. I'm not a very large grower, and I say save. And now it's what is shown that he uses all the select here another year, all the data that have been auctioned is used to couple it on the number of square meters and the number of plants that I have been filled in with this option. Takes a little time for loading. It's quite a complicated measure I've created, I think. Cultivation overview. That's now shown over here. Maybe it's too much for roses. That should work for last for current year. Try it again. Ah, now it's working. You see the roses, pieces planted, supplied 12,900, not sold. Supply piece planted. This is the number of supplied divided by the pieces planted, square meters, and you can see a revenue per square meter if you do this. So if I have all my roses and I know how much square meters I have, you can directly see how much, what's your revenue per square meter, and what's the average price for that thing. I now have done roses, but for example, if you have some different kinds of products and you know exactly how much square meters you have, the number of plants is not always necessary, but you can use the number of plants or the number of square meters or both. It's free to choose. But you got within this, you can very useful see what the revenue is for per square meter, for example. You can see that here in the graphic. You can see it is also in a table per week. And for example, if I have roses and I have Alstroemeria, I can create a second one as well. I say what product, Alstroemeria. I'll use both groups. Area, but for this one I don't know exactly how much pieces, but I only know my square meters, that is 750, and I say save. There it is, the piece of plant that I did not fill in, so it is empty. Here the piece supplied, not sold, and you can see also here for Alstroemeria what the revenue per square meter is. But this report you can use to check that kind of information. This is the last report that's currently available. At this moment we are working on an extra statistics report that will show your auction positioning over a longer period. For example, for the last month, you can see exactly for each day from the order in which you was auctioned, and you see the total number of growers within the auction group you're using, and you will see what your position is, and you will see that over a longer period. So it can be very useful to see from, hey, what's the price development over a longer period? That's the report that will be added within a few weeks to Insights. That's all I have to tell today. Are there any questions?
Yes, Marco, can you, in the daily report or in other reports, can we see the weight of the flowers?
Yes, you can. You can see that here when you click on the product. You can see for your own what your weight is. But if you want to see it for all other growers, you can only see the main characteristic, but you can also use, if you like, a filter on a specific weight. If I check here, for example, 55 as a wave, you can see within this graphic is only one lot is shown, but in a normal auction group, you will always see then all the products with the same wave. So you cannot see the wave of other growers directly, but what you can do use is setting a filter. So it's shown only the products that have been the same weight.
Okay. Okay. But you have to choose the certain way that you want to check.
Yes. Okay. And it's one, yeah, it's you can only select filters over here from this, from what you deliver for yourself. If you have, for example, only 60 gram as a weight that you use, you can only set a filter on 60. So you can only compare within daily report what you do for yourself with other growers that have the same characteristics used.
Yes, but you can have only one parameter at a time.
No, you can set more. Right? It is only showing one, but it's something to do with the filter I have over here. But if you remove this and I say I want to see for example maturity stages, you can select multiples. You can also select both of them, for example, for the number of stems per bunch. So you can multi-select. But if you multi-select these things, for example, the minimum length, I say 50 and 60. You can see 50 and 60, but you can't see what is 50 or 60 with other growers. Yeah, you can see it over here because it's the main characteristic. Eh? You see 60 and 50 as main characteristic in the pop-up, but that's only because it's the main characteristic in this case.
Yeah, okay. In the opening stage, you can also see the only one at a time, or you can choose more than one.
Sorry, I didn't exactly understand what you...
The opening stage.
The dashboard page, you mean?
Yes.
No, I mean the opening stage.
The opening stage.
Sorry. Yeah, what's the opening page? Is the first page you use in Insights or is it something else?
No, the opening stage.
Opening stage, yeah, it's something as a characteristic, I think.
Yes, but
yeah, it's maturity, I think. It's,
yeah. You can choose more than one.
I can multi-select. So, for example, 2-3 and 3-3, I can apply both. It's a maturity stage. It's called. And you see both of them now in this all the data you see.
And
you can see that if you click on it for your own data, you will see that the maturity stage is 2-3 or 3-3 at this moment.
Yeah, okay.
Where it is, over here. But for other growers, this is also a product with the same maturity.
Yeah, okay.
You can't see the maturity in detail. If it's 2-3 or 3-3, you can't see, but it's the same as you have set here in this filter.
Okay, and this filter of maturity stage will be available in the statistic and the market view as well?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Yeah, you can always, in every page, you can always choose specific characteristics. So if you have a detailed report, for example, what is showed in a custom report, you can also set, hey, I want to only see maturity stage 2-3 or 3-3. And you compare them as well with the custom report that showed in the statistics. You can say, hey, I want to compare the different stages. You can compare them with each other for your own products, but also for prices at Flora Holland.
Good. Okay. Understood.
Any other questions? Okay, then I will stop the recording for this demo.